welcome to part one of today's two-part series, live from the lake. I have my assistant here with me, Quinn. Your assignment for today, I believe, yes, tonight, is due in regards to looking up protest music. And normally what we do in class is we go through song after song, and we normally do it over like a 2-3 day spell of looking at old stuff, new stuff, all of that. So I'm going to do one. And then the hope is, I know that a lot of you have already turned in your assignment. The hope is that maybe you make a video. I have had a couple of people email me saying, well, yeah, you can use the music, but you got to do this and got to do that. I don't know how to do that. So maybe if you do it and show it. But if you want to post a video doing the exact same thing I'm about to do and do it however you want, I'll give you some extra credit, and then I'll maybe post it within my videos as we continue to go. So today we have a two-part series. First part is I'm going to look at Black Sabbath War Pigs, and then later I'm going to do a lecture on the draft, not the NFL draft that happened last week, but the draft Dodgers, ways to get out of it, what people begin to do, some of that, but we'll get to that later. That goes in with 30 notes. Are you ready, Quinn? She's ready. So, you know, I normally start with like Fortunate Son or something like that. But I really enjoy Black Sabbath's War Pigs. If you want to, if you have another device, just YouTube Black Sabbath War Pigs with lyrics and then you'll have it. There's, I think it's like the third one down has it. But it's like the best beginning ever to a song. It's like slow with sirens and quiet. And then it just boom and it hits with like the... was it like the snare drum and da-da, and then a little bit of guitar, and then it really gets cranked up, and in the beginning it is so good, and it starts with generals gathered in their masses. It goes, generals gathered in their masses, just like witches in black masses. Anyway, so I'm not going to sing all of that, but generals gathered in their masses. It's, the beginning is so awesome to this song. Generals gathered. Well, the name of the song is War Pigs, right? So it's talking about war and pigs and the gluttony and the money and the military-industrial complex, and really hits on a bunch of stuff. But it's really anti-politicians and making money and leaving the poor and the minorities to go fight on this actual war. We'll talk about how many people were drafted in and how you could get out of it in part two of the lecture today. But look at that beginning. Generals gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses, right? Generals, just like witches at black masses, thinking of that kind of witches as they're about to watch people being killed. Evil minds that plot destruction. Sorcerer of death's construction. And then it goes, this is a great one. In the field, the body's burning as the war machine keeps turning. Death and hatred to mankind, poisoning their brainwashed minds. And he goes, oh, Lord, yeah. It's like perfect Ozzy Osbourne way. But listen to that end. In the field, the body's burning as the war machine keeps turning. Right? So war machine, meaning the politicians that are working with the steel companies and the ammunition companies and the gun and all the money that's made on war. Right? I mean, we know, as we've talked about this in class throughout the year, after World War I, when all the books come out, that the only reason we joined is because of the money that was spent on making sure that the Allies had all kinds of stuff to fight the German Kaiser, and then we needed to make sure they won so that we could get our loans paid back. And that was the only reason we joined it. We know that. That's why there's petitioning against World War II until Pearl Harbor. And you know that stuff comes out after World War II as well. But looking at that, so as the war machine keeps turning, and then you have death and hatred to mankind poisoning their brainwashed minds. So that's hitting on a completely different side of things. That's talking about every American, that we're brainwashed, that the federal government or the war machine, the big politicians have brainwashed us that this war is good, that war is necessary. And that becomes the biggest part of it. Look at that. Quinn's using this time to go snatch herself a popsicle. Good job. That was sneaky. So, I just, that's getting into all of that. And that's that when you talk about fortunate son, that's a huge part of it too.
Dad, do you see me in the camera behind you?
Yeah, I can see you. You're doing great. Now I'm talking to the class here, as you can see. And so then it gets, and then it pumps up the song, and then it goes, really gets pumped up, and then it goes, politicians hide themselves away. They only started the war. Why should they go out and fight? They leave that to the poor. Oh, Lord, yeah. No. Okay. Now we've got to pay attention to the lyrics. All right. So look at that again. Politicians hide themselves away. They only started the war. Why should they go out to fight? They leave that role to the poor. Right? This idea of the politicians. Remember, I'm going to tell you in a little bit. When Lyndon Johnson escalates the war and suddenly we're sending 125,000 troops there at all times, all the politicians are for that. I'll get to that in part two. Quinn. You got to be quiet. I'm talking. And so they leave that role to the poor. You're going to see a ton of that in the music that you've been listening to. And then then it goes to the third verse, which is fantastic. Time will tell on their power minds, making war just for fun, treating people just like pawns in chess. Wait till their judgment day comes. I mean, I didn't think Ozzy could get this good. This was pre, like, massive amounts of drugs, Ozzy. I'm guessing this is part of the drugs, Ozzy. But look, listen to that. Time will tell on their power minds, making war just for fun, treating people just like pawns in chess. Wait till their judgment day comes. So it's getting into that. It's just so good going into that. These politicians are just, well, no, it's not just maybe about money. It could also just be about power and that they've been brainwashed that this war is necessary and that fighting for democracy and all of that. But you're seeing this becomes politics. Like, I guarantee you've heard this song before. It's like, look it up and listen to it. You know, I've heard this song. You just never paid attention that this song is really protesting the federal government. You just thought how great the actual song is. But then getting into these politicians making these decisions and making these decisions sitting in the Capitol in Washington, D.C., and they don't have anything to, they have no loss in here. They're not going to go fight. They're going to have deferments. They're not going to get, they're not going to be in the front lines. They're not going to be walking through the jungle getting killed by booby traps or by Viet Cong. They're making war just for fun, treating people just like pawns in chess. Wait till their judgment day comes. And then he goes with, oh, Lord. Yeah, I love that part. But I love that. Then getting at that last part. Wait till their judgment day comes. And that's what you see a lot of them as well. And so that's where if you, I guarantee a lot of you probably use Fortunate Son by CCR. That has nothing really to do with the war. That has so much more to do with what Black Sabbath is talking about as well, as these politicians and people that are brainwashed screaming war, yet the people that are screaming it are not the ones going out and fighting. That's why I ain't no senator's son, yeah, from Fortunate Son, you know, screaming, yeah, this war is great and America, America, but yeah, we'll see if you go over there. We'll see if you go actually go over there and fight. And so we'll get into that a little bit in part two. I encourage you, once again, if you want to, make your own video. Do exactly what I'm doing, minus the assistant with the dreamsicle, and get into it. And make the video.
Where's the popsicle?
Oh, sorry. Oh, got it. Put that on. I'll put it within my video and just chunk it in and say, hey, here's such and such talking about this particular Beatles song, and I'll give you some points for it or give you some extra credit for it. And I think that could be really fun towards maybe the end of this week or early next week. I could just pop those in there. That's a piece of cake for me. Even I can figure that out. And so if you want to do that, that'd be great. I know you've already done your assignment, but a lot of us don't have a ton to do. That's probably my favorite one to do. I'll give you some hints. BYOB by, who sings BYOB? Who is it? Anyways, that song's Bring Your Own Bombs is is really good. That's a new song. That's about the war in Iraq. That's a fantastic. There's some swearing in there, but it's really good. It's kind of the new age of Black Sabbath. They do a ton of stuff. Any of those songs, it doesn't have to be a Vietnam song necessarily, that if you want to do your own video, it could be something else as well. So it'd be really fun. I think it'd be cool. So hopefully maybe a couple of you do it. Say goodbye for part one, Quinn.